press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, welcome back to video classes by Siddhaganga. See, in the previous classes we have discussed about the blood and the lymph, the different compositions of blood and lymph and their functions, right? See, today in this class we will start the circulatory system, right? See, before entering into human circulation and human circulatory system, in case of human beings, we need to understand, in case of other animals, including means the animals that are belonging to the subphylum vertebrata, right? How this heart is present, another kuda we will discuss, right? So in this class, so I will tell you the circulatory pathways, right? Circulatory pathways. Yes. See, according to the studies, there are two types of circulatory systems are observed in case of animals, right? One is said to be open circulatory system. Open circulatory system. And the second one is closed circulatory system, right? See, there are two systems of circulation observed in case of animals. The first thing is the open circulatory system. See, in case of this type of system of circulation seen in case of animals belonging to the phylum Arthropoda, belonging to the phylum Arthropoda, the animals are said to be arthropods, molluscans. The animals that are belonging to the phylum Mollusca, right? Arthropods and Mollusca, right? These are the two different animals. Invertebrates, even invertebrates, then vertebrates are left. The animals belonging to arthropods and molluscans means Arthropoda is a phylum, arthropods means the animals that are belonging to the Arthropoda, right? So in this system, the blood is pumped by the heart into open spaces or into cavities, are also called sinuses, through large vessels, right? See here, in case of open circulatory system, the blood is pumped by the heart into the open cavities. They are called sinuses, blood sinuses, where the blood is accumulated in the cavities. Directly the heart pumps the blood into cavities, right, through the large vessels. Whereas in case of closed circulatory system, see, this system seen in case of animals belonging to annelids or annelida. See, annelida is a phylum belonging to the phylum annelida, annelids, and chordata, right? Chordata. The entire chordates, in entire chordates you will be getting closed circulatory system. The phylum chordata and the animals belonging to chordata are called chordates anbeku, annelids anbeku, annelida, annelids, right? So annelida is an invertebrate, ನೋಡಿ ನಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಇದು ನಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ ಡೇಟಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅನಿಲಿಡ ರೈಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳಲ್ಲ ಅರ್ಥ್ ವರ್ಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಲೀಚ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸೊ ಅನಿಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸಬ್ ಫೈಲಾ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಟೆಬ್ರೇಟಾ ರೈಟ್ ವರ್ಟೆಬ್ರೇಟಾದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಎಂಟೈರ್ ವರ್ಟೆಬ್ರೇಟಾ ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಫಿಶಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಆಂಫಿಬಿಯನ್ಸ್ ರೆಪ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಸಬ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಫೈಲಮ್ ವರ್ಟೆಬ್ರೇಟಾ ಸಬ್ ಫೈಲಮ್ ವರ್ಟೆಬ್ರೇಟಾ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟು ಎ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಎ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓಪನ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಯೂಶಲಿ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೇಸಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಸೊ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವೆರಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಪನ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಸಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ವೆನ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಂಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟೀಸ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಬಾತಸ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಪನ್ ಎಸ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ರೈಟ್ ಓಪನ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಓಪನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೀಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಪನ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಬಾತಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಾತಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎ ನೋನ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರೋದು ನಾವು ನೋನ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಸಿ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರಿ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರಿ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಿಲರಿ ರೈಟ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಸಿ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಕೆಪಿಲರಿ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ the tissue fluid is present, right? So this one is tissue fluid, so here formed to be present, right? This one is tissue fluid, right? These are called cells, and this one is blood capillary, right? Capillary, okay. Whereas, see here, in case of open circulatory system, what happens? See, the blood is present in open spaces, right? The blood is present in the open spaces where the capillaries are absent. So then what happens? See, directly the cells are seems to be floating in the blood, right? So this is how the open circulatory system, that main difference between the open and closed circulatory system, right? So with this, you can also analyze that here there is a direct exchange of materials, right? The direct exchange of materials between the blood and cells seen in open circulatory system. Whereas in closed circulatory system, this tissue fluid, through the tissue fluid, the exchange of materials takes place, right? Like this. Exchange of materials takes place. So this is also considered one difference, right? Between the open and closed. So here the exchange of materials, substances through the fluid, right? Here direct contact, here indirect exchange anta helthane, right? Indirect exchange, you are getting a question. Indirect exchange of materials and substances takes place or occurs in anta kote options kotaga, then you have to take the closed circulatory system. Or they may produce, or they may give animals, right? Animals hesarugalannu kuda kodabahudu, right? So this is how the differences are recognized. And one more very important difference is, see, when you talk about the regulation, sir, how the regulation will be maintained in such cases, andre, see, in case of open circulatory system, there is no regulation. There is no regulation as the pressure is very less here. The blood pressure irodilla illi. The pressure will be very low pressure. So, whereas in case of closed circulatory system, the proper regulation of this mechanism happened. See, illenagutte, movement of blood in the capillaries, the movement of blood in the capillaries is regulated. And also, pressure will be more. Right? Illi blood pressure irutte. Yakandre, see, when the blood is pumped by the heart with a highest pressure into arteries, right? And then arteries branched to become these capillaries, right? So capillaries lumen is less than the lumen of the arteries. So obviously what happens when this, see, this one is artery, right? This one is artery. When it branches into the number of capillaries, obviously what happens? Its lumen reduces. See here. Its lumen reduces. When the blood is moving here with high pressure, then see in the broad lumen, the pressure is more in the arteries, and then it branched to become the number of capillaries. Obviously, more than that pressure can be expected in these capillaries. Yes or no? So in these capillaries, the more pressure is expected, right? So than this pressure. So this is how the blood pressure will be more, and here no capillaries. So hence the pressure is diluted, right? So illi pressure sikkalla, illi pressure sikkutte. Illi exchange of materials direct agalla, indirect agutte. But in case of open exchange of materials, illi direct agutte. Illi yavade regulations irodilla, right? Controlling method illa. Illi enagutte, proper regulation will be present. And here more efficient, and here less efficient of circulation. Here more efficient of circulation anta helabodu. So in this closed circulatory system, we'll be getting more efficient blood circulation seen. More efficiently, the blood is circulated, but here less efficiently, because when the cavities where exactly present, there only you will be able to come across this blood, because cavity idda jagadalli matra blood anna nodtivi naavu. Cavity illade iro kade tissues kadege blood hoguvanta chances thumba kadame irutte. So hagagi so illi proper efficient circulation anta naavu nodlik barala, less efficient than this, right? So this is how the two different pathways or two different circulatory systems observed in case of animals, right? Next. See, in case of vertebrates, because we'll talk directly in case of vertebrates, invertebrates are not required. See, in case of vertebrates, you will be getting the different animals, right? Fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals, right? These are the five different classes comes under Vertebrata. Vertebrata is a subphylum that comes under phylum Chordata, right? So Chordata dalli vertebrata. Vertebrata dalli aidu super classes anta nenpidu. Aidu classes anta nenpidu. There will be two super classes anta helthi. One is Pisces and other one is Tetrapoda, right? Pisces means fishes. So namage basically what five classes anta nenpidukoli. There are five classes: the fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. See, for competitive purpose, you need to remember which type of circulation takes place in these animals, right? So first, see, in every vertebrates, you will be getting a muscular heart with the chambers, right? So ellodrallu kuda yenirutte, the heart is said to be the heart, right? Heart is said to be muscular. Means what? It is made up of muscles, right? It is a muscular, right? And chambered means consisting of chambers, right? Generally, in case of heart, blood receiving chamber is called atrium. So, enanta karitare, blood receiving chambers are called atrium, or in plural, atria. Atria, atrium, even this one is called auricle. Nodi nenpidkole, ivella words galu gottidkole. Atria, plural word, atrium, right? Auricle, blood receiving chamber. Idu enagirutte, blood receiving chamber. Elle atria, atrium, auricle anta word bandre, which receives blood in the heart, right? So it is the chamber of the heart. Next, ventricles. See, ventricles andre idu plural word, blood pumping chambers antane karitare. Ventricles are called blood pumping chambers. Ventricle singular helodadre ventricle, right? Ventricle, okay. Atrium and ventricle. So these are the chambers, two types of chambers found to be present in case of heart. So in these animals, the heart is said to be muscular and branched, means chambered heart, right? So let me tell you how the heart is present and which type of circulation seen in case of fishes, right? In case of fishes, you will be getting a single circulation, right? Whereas in case of amphibians and reptiles, you will be getting double circulation, but it is said to be incomplete, right? And in case of birds and mammals, complete and double circulation. See here, incomplete double circulation. In case of amphibians and reptiles, except crocodiles, crocodiles belonging to the reptiles, right? Crocodiles, birds and mammals will be getting complete. Crocodiles, reptiles, but reptiles are kuda illi tagondre. Crocodiles, birds and mammals, closed, means specifically complete circulation takes place, complete and double circulation. And here amphibians and reptiles, incomplete double circulation, right? And here fishes, single circulation takes place. Okay, let me tell you how it will be occur. Now, in case of fishes, see, when we talk about fishes, the heart is right down two-chambered. In case of fishes, the heart is two-chambered, right? With the one auricle, or else one atrium and one ventricle, right? What is atrium? Right? Auricle, blood receiving chamber. What is ventricle? Is the chamber of the heart that pumps the blood, right? So heart is said to be having two chambers, right? One blood receiving chamber and one blood pumping chamber, right? In this case, so the blood is carried into gills. See, gills. What are gills? Gills are the respiratory organs in case of fishes, right? Gills are the respiratory organs. So the blood is carried into gills for oxygenation. For what purpose? For oxygenation, right? So idu ondu important point nenpidkoli, very important point. In case of fishes, the blood is carried into gills for oxygenation, right? And again, from the gills, the blood is carried into body parts. And from the body parts, again the blood is sent back into heart. So this is how, from the heart, the blood is carried into gills, and from the gills to body parts, after getting oxygenated blood is moving from gills to body parts, and from the body parts, after receiving oxygen by all the cells, then what happens? So then that the blood is said to be deoxygenated blood, right? And this one is said to be oxygenated blood. So this is how the blood circulation takes place in case of fishes. See, from the heart to gills, gills to body parts, and again from body parts to heart. So this is only through the veins, and usually arteries are absent here. See, in case of fishes, arteries are absent, and in case of fishes, the heart is said to be venous heart. The heart is said to be venous heart. So you are getting a separate competitive question as, what is venous heart? The venous heart is consisting of only veins, and in which animals do you come across? In case of fishes, right? So this is how the fishes, and here you will be getting only one circulation, right? So hence it is said to be single circulation. See, one more important point you need to remember, that is single circulation. Okay, na? This one is single circulation. This is the type of circulation seen in case of fishes, right? So next, we'll move on to the amphibians. See, if you talk about amphibians, amphibians and reptiles. See, in case of reptiles, I'll tell you, except crocodiles. See, in this case, the heart is three-chambered. Heart is three-chambered with the two auricles, right? Two auricles and one ventricle. Ventricle. This one is incompletely divided. Antanu kuda karitare. Incompletely divided ventricle. See, you need to remember. So, here incompletely divided andre allige consider to be one ventricle, right? So, there will be three chambers. Okay. So, this is how the three-chambered heart, it will performing. See, three chambers means what happens? See, consider this one is right like this. Okay. There are three chambers. The one is the first two chambers are auricles, right? And this one is right auricle and left auricle. And this one is ventricle, only one ventricle, right? So here what happens, this right side means right auricle which receive deoxygenated blood, right? So left auricle receives oxygenated blood. This receives oxygenated blood. In case of human beings also the same thing, right? See, here the right auricle receives deoxygenated blood and left auricle receives oxygenated blood, and so both are bring into the ventricles. So the ventricles consisting of mixed blood, right? And this pumps into body parts. So this pumps into body parts into head, into lungs, or even gills in case of larval amphibians. Pretty gills are also said to be respiratory structures. In case of terrestrial amphibians and reptiles, lungs are said to be respiratory structures. So they are different, right? Even the skin, but through skin also they will respire, yes or no? So in the chapter respiration, right, you are all well aware of that respiration through the skin is called cutaneous respiration. Enanta karithara adana cutaneous respiration, right? Nenpidkoli, cutaneous, where the skin is gelatinous, okay, mucilaginous, moisturized. So the gotirkoli, through the skin also they are able to respire, and through the gills they are able to respire, and through the lungs also they are able to respire. So they can yavadadru respiratory structure tagona, right? So take consider all, and through this, say, mixed blood is pumped by these ventricle, and ventricle pump the blood into body parts, head and lungs. But for lungs and to lungs and gills for oxygenation. I'll get deoxygenated blood get oxygenated over here and again come back to the left auricle, right? And head, generally oxygenated blood is pumped into the blood. Generally through this ventricle, the mixed blood gets circulated, right? So hence it is said to be mixed circulation and also said to be incomplete double circulation. Why? Because the deoxygenated blood coming from the body parts to the right auricle, and similarly coming from the lungs to the left auricle. See, here the two separate bloods are received but pumped as a mixed blood, right? So here said to be double circulation, but it is incomplete, not complete double. Okay, if the ventricle is chambered, so then obviously considered as double ಅಂತ ಆಗ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್. ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್, ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ರೈಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ so this incomplete double circulation showing heart is said to be arterio venous heart antanu karittare, arterio venous heart. So adonu nenpittukoli, arterio venous heart. So here the next come to the crocodiles, birds, and in case of mammals, crocodiles, birds and mammals, right? So in case of crocodiles, birds and mammals, the heart is said to be, the heart is said to be four chambers are present, two atria and two ventricles, right? There are four chambers are present, two auricles and two ventricles, and two auricles are blood receiving chambers and two ventricles are blood pumping chambers, and they are completely divided and they are separate, right? See here, I'll write very simple diagram just to understand the concept, right? See, this one is right auricle, this one is left auricle, right? And this one is left ventricle, this one is right ventricle, right? Like this. See, ventricles has divided into two chambers. Ventricle is divided into two chambers. Auricle is divided into two chambers, right auricle and left auricle. See what happens here. See, the right auricle receive deoxygenated blood. Okay, I'll write in short form, DOB, deoxygenated blood, right? So this left auricle receive oxygenated blood, right? Oxygenated blood. And the same blood is moving into the left auricle. So oxygenated blood is moving into the left auricle, left ventricle. Left ventricle pumps which blood? That one is oxygenated blood. Similarly, the right auricle sends the deoxygenated blood, that is deoxygenated blood, right? So from here, this ventricle pumps the blood into the lungs, right? So it sends the blood to the lungs for respiration, right? Means for what purpose? For oxygenation. See, after this oxygenation, what happens? From the lungs, the blood is moving into the left auricle, that is the same. Yes or no? This one, sorry. Yes, let it be like this. Okay, this oxygenated blood, right? This one is oxygenated blood. After oxygenation, see, lungs are the respiratory structures. So as the right ventricle pumps the blood into the lungs, okay, through the pulmonary artery, right? So this sends back, after oxygenation, the blood is coming back to the left auricle, right? Left auricle through the pulmonary veins. So this is how this is said to be separate circulation, one separate circulation. The another circulation, see, after receiving this left auricle receiving oxygenated blood sent into left ventricle, from the left ventricle, what happens? The blood is moving into the body parts. The blood is moving into body parts, right? From the body parts, what happens? Finally, the blood, then this one is oxygenated blood is moving into body parts. Then after utilizing oxygen, what happens? So lifting of carbon dioxide from the body parts, then it become deoxygenated blood. So this deoxygenated blood is, then what happens? So coming into the right auricle, right? Right auricle. So this clearly shows that the two separate circulations which are said to be complete. So usually this right side of the heart is, the right side of the heart is receiving deoxygenated blood and pumping deoxygenated blood, right? Receiving and pumping the same blood. And the left side of the heart chambers, left auricle and left ventricle, receiving and pumping of the same means oxygenated blood, right? So like a deoxygenated blood is received and pumped separately. Oxygenated blood is received and pumped separately. So blood get not mixed in the ventricles, right? As the ventricle is branched into two separate branches. Hence, this is said to be complete double circulation. So, enantara idana complete double circulation, right? So, this is about the different type of circulations seen in case of animals, in case of vertebrates. So, let me explain the human circulatory system, because in this chapter physiology, we are studying specifically the circulation in case of human beings, right? See, I'll take human circulatory system. So, this human circulatory system or human blood vascular system or blood vascular system, right? So, in this system including heart, next the body fluid called blood, right? And the next is network of blood vessels, network of blood vessels. See, this system comprises of a heart, blood and vessels, right? So, in case of human circulatory system, so when we talk about first you need to study the detail structure of heart. Heart structure na first neat kalibeko, practice madbeko, right? So, then the functions of heart, functioning area of the heart you need to study. So, let me tell the heart. Structure of heart, right? We will study in detail the structure of heart. See, where this heart is located means and is protected. It is protected by a membranous bag like structure called pericardium. Please note down this, very important. In case of human beings, the heart is well protected by a membranous sac like structure or bag like structure antane karidhi. Membranous bag of the heart is known as pericardium. So, very important, you need to understand this. This pericardium is basically two-membraned structure, right? Pericardium is basically two-membraned structure. So, two membranes are, see, the first one is known as outer parietal membrane and inner visceral. Inner visceral pericardium. So outer parietal pericardium. So basically, pericardium has two membranes. One is outer parietal pericardium and visceral pericardium, right? And further, see this parietal pericardium anta em karithivi. This parietal pericardium has subdivided into two membranes. It has subdivided into two membranes. That is, outer fibrous outer fibrous connective tissue one, that is outer parietal and inner parietal. See, outer parietal pericardium antane karithivi, outer fibrous connective tissues. See, this outer parietal pericardium is made up of fibrous connective tissue, and inner parietal membrane is made up of squamous epithelium. See, the squamous epithelium is a flat, made up of flattened cells, thin epithelial tissue, right? A lining tissue antane karithivi idana, squamous lining tissue just lines this fibrous connective tissue. Nenpidkole. So the parietal membrane is like this. See, yes. See, this one is the fibrous connective tissue. This one is the fibrous connective tissue. Right? Outer fibrous connective tissue. And just below this, there will be the presence of a thin squamous epithelium. Right? So this one is the thin squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium, right? So this together constitute this outer parietal pericardium, right? Outer parietal pericardium. And when we talk about this inner pericardium, so this inner pericardium is again made up of one more layer of squamous epithelium. This one is inner visceral pericardium. Inner visceral pericardium. So this two enagutte, this constitute pericardium. This two idike pericardium. So this is how the pericardium has two main membranes, right? One is outer parietal and other one is inner visceral. So this inner visceral is made up of squamous epithelium, and so this outer parietal pericardium has again two, that is fibrous connective tissue and the squamous epithelium. The fibrous one is the outer, this yellow color shows outer, that is the fibrous connective tissue. And just below that, one more, very much close to that, very much thin, is squamous epithelium. So this is how the pericardium is a bag-like structure where it gives protection to the heart. And this squamous epithelium, as I told you, just below this parietal means the outer ಫೈಬ್ರಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ. ಈ ಫೈಬ್ರಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೀಲಿಯಂ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೆರಸ್ ಲೇಯರ್. ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನು? ಸೆರಸ್ ಲೇಯರ್, ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಸೆರಸ್, ಎಸ್ ಇ ಆರ್ ಓ ಯು ಎಸ್, ಸೆರಸ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಲೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆರಿಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಮ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಔಟರ್ ಪೆರೈಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ವಿಸರಲ್, ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್. There will be a fluid is known as pericardial fluid. Pericardial or visceral fluid. This one is also called, serous fluid or pericardial fluid, right? This one is pericardial fluid. Okay, so overall this pericardium, the two membranes of the pericardium, outer parietal and inner visceral, but inno sari nent madkoli, the structure of heart bartha idivi. When we are before entering, we need to learn its protective covering, so that it is, heart is protected by a membranous bag-like structure, right? That membranous bag-like structure is called pericardium. So this pericardium further has two main membranes. One is outer and other one is inner. Outer is called parietal pericardium, right? Inner one is called visceral pericardium. The outer parietal pericardium enide adralli matte eradu membrane anta na consider madkolana. Ondu outer fibrous tissue, connective tissue irutte. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೀಲಿಯಂ, ರೈಟ್? ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೀಲಿಯಂ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೀಲಿಯಂ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಥಿನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆರಸ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್, ಅದನ್ನೇ ಸೆರಸ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ವಿಸರಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಮಸ್ ಎಪಿಥೀಲಿಯಂ. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌನ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪೆರಿಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಲ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಓವರ್ಆಲ್ this pericardium and the pericardial fluid, see, pericardium, that consisting of the pericardial fluid, is used just to protect the heart. So it prevents shocks and absorbs shocks anta helbodu, right? So adike idu shock absorber tara irudu. See, as in case of brain, meninges anta helthivu nodi hage illi. So this pericardium, it gives purely protections, right? And inner to the pericardium, so the heart is present, right? And then next we will enter into the heart wall. So in the next class, I'll start with the heart wall and the structure of heart, right? Hope you are enjoying the classes. Thank you. Have a nice day.